Children's Television Workshop presents Sesame Street, show 1546, produced in color at 3 Stellatate, New York.
So I better see if they can hear me. Yoo-hoo! Anybody home? No. You know that's Oscar playing a trick, don't you? Oscar, will you tell Buffy I want to see her? No. Okay, Oscar, okay. I know you think your little no sign popping in and out is very funny. This is beginning to get to me. Oscar, Oscar, come on. Tell Buffy I'd like her to come out now. No. Oscar. Oscar. Oscar, I want you to come out here. I want to talk to you. No. Yes, come here.
Hi now, there, Susan.
Don't you hi there, Susan, me. Now, I understand your grouch, and I know you think playing tricks on people is very funny. But I'm telling you, this one is making me very angry because you have no right to keep me from seeing my friend Buffy. Now, I'm going to tell you once and for all, will you ask Buffy to come out here?
You know, Susie, you really ought to learn to control yourself. I mean, I'd be delighted to ask Buffy to come out here, but there's no way I can do that.
Why not?
Because Buffy is already out here. Look, there she is playing with the kids. There's Cody and... Gotcha.
Thank you. And now, Fred, the singer, singing the,
rhyming song.
Rhyming song.
My name is the
Fred.
My name is Fred. They call me Fred. When I go out, I put my hat upon my
head.
My name is Fred. They call me Fred. And when I eat, I butter up a slice of. And when I eat, I butter up a slice of.
Fred. Fred.
My name is Fred. They call me Fred. And every night when I get tired, I go to
bed.
My name is Fred. They call me Fred. And every night when I get tired,
he gets fired.
We take you now to Kermit the Frog with another fast-breaking news story.
Yeah, well, you better take a wide picture of it, you know, because his nose grows and we don't want to blow it. You know, the picture, not the nose. Oh, oh, hi, hello, hi, ho there. Kermit the Frog here. And today we're speaking to you from the workshop of Geppetto, which is the home of the world-famous wooden boy, Pinocchio.
And, hey, Frog, Are we on TV?
Yeah.
Oh, hi.
Okay. Now, it is said that when Pinocchio tells a lie, his nose grows and gets longer. And when he tells the truth, the nose gets shorter.
I want to say hello to my mother, the oak, and the hi, Ma, and to the saplings, Myrtle and Magnolia.
Excuse me, Pinocchio, but is it indeed true that when you tell a lie, your nose does get longer?
Yeah. You want to see me lie and have my nose get longer?
Yes, would you please?
Sure, they come from all around for that.
Okay, stand by, folks, because in just 1 second now, Pinocchio is going to tell a lie and his nose is going to get longer.
Get this, folks. My name is Abraham Lincoln and I'm 500 feet tall.
How about that? You see that, folks? The nose did indeed get longer. Talk about a nose for news.
You call that longer? I'll show you longer. This is longer. I am 1,000 million years old and I can lick Superman.
I tell you what, Pinocchio, why don't you tell a little bit of truth now and make this nose shorter, huh?
Okay, folks, here's shorter. My name is Pinocchio.
Oh, that's very good. And if you tell truth again, it'll get a little bit shorter, huh?
Okay, and I love jelly beans.
Wonderful. Okay, folks, isn't that great,
and now,
Pinocchio,
for the folks
here?
In television land who missed it the first time, here's longer again. My name is Cinderella, and for breakfast, I ate two dragons.
That's fine,
Pinocchio.
And then
Pinocchio. I ate the whole world, and then I sat on the moon, and then I became the President of the United States.
Wait a second, Pinocchio.
I drank a million trillion glasses of milk, and then I ate airplanes, and I put the sun in my pocket.
This is Kermit the Frog at the end of Pinocchio's nose.
And I swallowed a whale.
Oh, no.
And then I turned orange and yellow and green.
Oh, no.
And then...
Stop your nose. I want to get off.
What?
I say, would you please tell the truth and make this thing shorter so I can get off of this thing?
Okay. My name is Pinocchio.
Oh, this is Kermit the Frog.
Ouch.
What's he excited about? Oh, about his car. It's short. Hey, what's going on here? No, it's long. Short. Long. Short. they go. But not far. I think the car is going to be short again. Very... Watch out! Short.
I'm gonna tell you where it's at. This is a story about a hat. A cat with a hat? A fat cat with a hat. The fat cat with a hat sat on a mat. A bat scared the fat cat.
You made me make my hat flat,
said the fat cat to the bat.
Now scat!
And that was at.
Híjole, qué calor, mano. It's so hot. Oh, well, no wonder. Look at that hot sun up there. Oh, I'm dying in these clothes.
Snow, what's Snow doing down here? How am I going to the beach? Snow, I mean sand. Oh, what is this? This is crazy. I don't understand.
Oh, so hot.
Hey!
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
I should be over there with these warm clothes on.
I got a swimming suit on. I should be over on the beach. Yeah.
Hey! Let's switch, man.
That's a good idea.
Oh, here we go. Reset. And...
Yep. Here we go. Made it, hot dog.
This is more like it, man. Yeah.
Look at me. I'm in the sun. In the sun. Go on, baby. Get him.
Oh, now I feel right in it. Yeah, I think I'll build a snowman. Oh, there goes the body right there. And I put a head on there.
My trusty old beach ball and my beach blanket.
Hey, man.
What's the matter with you? You're funny. I'm going to get you, man. All right.
T. That's a nice letter. T starts some very good words like toes. And toes can be very useful. They're good for scratching, playing.
Come on, cat, let me out.
Tickling. Even sneaking up tippy toe on people.
Ah!
And how about kicking things up? Why, with toes you can tell how cold the water is. Yes, toes sure have a lot of uses. But best of all, you can wiggle them. A gorilla? Toes, that's a good T word.
A jolly old fellow named Joe once said to his lap, "Well, hello. When I'm sitting, you're here. But it's never quite clear. When I'm standing up, where do you go?"
This is a tea.
What's this?
Oh, this is a tea.
What's it for?
Well, it's for tickle, tilt, tap, tar, trumpet, tuba, tear, twine, tangle, twirl, tie, teeter, topple, and turn, take, train, top, tin, tang, tick, tock, tune, tab, table, took, and toss.
You forgot two.
Which?
Trash.
Oh.
And ticket. Here you are.
Thank you.
All right.
Ears, nose, stomach, arms, legs.
Welcome to Professor Grover's world-famous lecture on parts of the body. You are going to love it. It's going to be such fun. And here we have it, the part of the body we are going to talk about today. Da-da-da-da-da-da! The head! And here we have a genuine, authentic, cute little head.
I never felt so silly in all my life.
Okay, it's okay. Now, you will notice that while a head is part of the body, it has other features on it that are also parts of the body. Let us look at some of them. Now, for instance, over here, yes, right here, the head is covered with this long stringy stuff.
Stringy stuff?
Now, some people think that it is spaghetti.
I don't believe it.
But don't you believe it? No, it is not spaghetti, it is hair.
That's better, Grover.
Now, on either side of the head and kind of hidden by the spaghetti here.
It's Grover.
By the hair, excuse me. There are two little sticky out things that kind of look like handles. See right here? Yeah, there's one, and there's one just like it on the other side right there. Mm-hmm. And those are called head handles. They could be head handles. Let us try it out. Let us go and lift the head by the handles.
No, Grover, I don't think... Grover!
Yes, they could be head handles, useful for carrying a head around with.
They are not.
But they are not. I was wrong. They are not called head handles. They are called ears. Yes, and people use them to hear with.
That's right, Grover. That's right.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, over here is what we call the forehead, Grover. Right below the spaghetti there. Here, I'll go out
it's
in front
spaghetti,
and show you. I'm sorry, the hair. I will go out and show you. Right here is the forehead, and just below the forehead, there are the eyes. There are two eyes there, and you use the eyes to see with. Hello there.
Grover, go on.
Oh, yes, excuse me. And now, right over here is an interesting part of the body. There is great confusion about this part of the body. I wonder how many people think that is a belly button.
Nobody thinks it's a belly button, Grover.
Probably nobody. But it is, of course, a nose. Yes, and we use the nose to smell things with, like pretty flowers. And now, at last, here is one of the most useful parts of all. Right here, the mouth. Yes, it can do so many things. For instance, you can use the mouth to eat with.
That's true, that's right.
Uh-huh. And to talk with.
That's true.
And
uh-huh.
To whistle. Very good. And to smile with. Uh-huh. And those are all the things a mouth can do. Thank you.
Wait, Grover. You forgot something.
Or what? Something else the mouth can do?
Yeah.
What's that? Oh, it can kiss. Oh, Maria.
G-Train! One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
Oh, boy.
Hi there, Bert. What you got there?
Oh, hey, Ernie. I just wrapped this present here.
A present? A present, Bert? Oh, wow, what a surprise. Oh, boy, am I surprised, Bert. Gee, you just shouldn't have done it. What is it?
Oh, Ernie. Oh, no, see, what it
no,
is.
No, don't
see,
tell
Ernie.
Me. Don't tell me what it is. You'll spoil the surprise. Let me just guess what it is. I know. I bet it's a new football.
Oh, no, Ernie. See,
you just knew I wanted a new football, didn't you, Bert?
Wrong.
Just
wrong,
one second,
Ernie.
Bert. I'll be
no,
right
Ernie,
back.
I'm trying to explain you. See, you got to... Ernie. Ernie. Ernie.
Go, you Northwest. Turn. Okay, I got my football helmet on. I'm all ready to open my new football.
No.
No?
It's not a football.
It's not a football.
No, take that silly helmet off. It is not
no.
a football helmet.
Not a football.
Look,
okay, don't tell me what it is. I will guess what it is if it's not a football.
Okay.
It is.
Okay,
I've
had it.
It's the right size for a cake.
No, no.
It's
Ernie,
a cake, Bert. No,
Ernie,
I knew
I'm
that's what it is.
You.
It's a cake. Just 1 second, Bert. I'll be right back.
Oh, Ernie. Ernie, look, it is not. Okay, that does it. Wow. Ernie!
Okay, I got my napkin on. I have my fork, and I'm all ready to eat my cake. So,
Ernie, hold it.
What?
It is not a cake.
Oh,
Ernie,
not a cake,
old pal.
Huh?
Ernie, old pal.
I'll just keep guessing.
No,
then,
you
huh?
don't have to keep on guessing, Ernie. You
well,
don't
no, don't,
have to keep it all.
Don't
because...
tell me what it is, Bert, because you'll spoil the surprise. I'll just guess it, okay?
Oh,
now, don't
Ernie.
Worry. Hey, I know what it must be. It must be a new lamp to put by my bed. Right, Bert?
No,
so
Ernie,
I can
Ernie.
Read. I knew that. Okay, just 1 second.
Ernie,
I'll be right back,
no,
Bert.
Don't go.
Hold
don't
on.
Go away. I'm
right.
trying to tell you. What was that? Ernie.
Okay.
Ernie, look, I'm trying
to... This is going to be the first book that I'm going to read with my brand new lamp.
No, it's not.
It's not?
It's not a lamp.
It's not a lamp?
No. It's not a lamp. It's not a football. It's not a cake. I am trying to tell you. Now, please stop guessing.
You're right, Bert. You're absolutely right.
Finally.
Because if I guess what it is, I'll spoil the surprise, right?
Right.
I'll just open
it. Well, not really. See what it is. It...
Okay.
Here Ernie, please don't open it. Ernie, you don't know what you're doing. Look, you don't understand. Now stop it. I'll try and explain to you. See, what that present is, it... Ernie...
Hey. See, it's a hat.
Yeah.
With a veil.
Yeah.
And flowers on top, too.
Right. Right.
Well, gee, Bert, I really am surprised.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you know who else is going to be surprised, Aaron?
Who?
My Aunt Matilda.
She is?
Yeah, when she finds out that you opened the surprise present, I bought for her!
Gee, Bert, did you buy one of these for her, too?
L. Light.
Huh? Oh, my God.
L.
L. Blues. L.
Fun to play, something in the bar, but I won't say. You won't know what it is unless you think real hard and try to guess. But I tell you what I'm gonna do, to give you some help, I'll give you a clue. Are you ready? Are you set? Let's go. First of all, guess what? It's an animal. And it's very tall. Sometimes it lives in a zoo. And it's orange in color. And you know what? It rhymes with the word laugh. Did you think of giraffe? Let's see if you're right. You ready? Okay. Giraffe.
Thank you.
One and one are two. Two and one are three. Three and one are four. Four and one are five. One and one are two. Two and one are three. Three and one are four. Four and one are five. Five. One from five is four. One from four is three. One from three is two. One from two is one. One from five is four. One from four is three. One from three is two. One from two is one.
I'm Jennifer. I live in the city. One day I went to visit my mommy's friend, Mrs. Wilson, who lives in the country. Mrs. Wilson has a big garden in back of her house. And you know what? She grows lots of things to eat right in her garden. The first thing Mrs. Wilson showed me was some big yellow squash that was growing out of the ground. Right behind us, there are a lot of tall plants. And Mrs. Wilson reached in and pulled off a piece of one of the plants. She opened up the green leaves, and there inside it was a corn on the cob. Mrs. Wilson said the leaves around it was called the husk. If you want. Later on, I picked some other things, like beets. They grow right in the ground, and you just pull them out by the leaves. Carrots are the same. All that shows above the ground are the leaves. The carrots are in the earth. This is the way tomatoes grow. It's called a vine. The tomato starts out green and turns red when it's ready to eat. And then you just pick it right off.
Coming off.
Oh, that's good, Jenny. Wash them good. We'll have them for lunch.
Okay.
After I picked all the vegetables from the garden, Mrs. Wilson cooked them in hot water, and I ate them for lunch.
Everything that we're having for lunch is something that we picked this morning.
Like the tomato.
Mm-hmm.
The carrot.
Right.
Corn.
That's right. Do you like corn?
Uh-huh.
Did you enjoy it? Did you have a good time?
Mm-hmm.
Next time I go to the store with Mommy, I'm going to tell her that lots of the things we eat grow right in the ground, just like in Mrs. Wilson's garden.
Thank you. And you've been locked out of the house? Don't worry, wrong way. Sunset and I will be right over.
I'm Billy Joe Jive, super crime fighting ace. My partner, Smart Susie Sunset, and I are on the case.
Wrong way Willie's gonna be in big trouble when his mom finds out he lost his key. When we found Wrong Way, he was looking mighty blue.
This is the second time this week I've lost my house key.
We've got to approach this scientifically. Maybe the super has an extra key.
I sure hope he's home.
Looks like we struck out here.
While you two look around, I'll shoot back to my pad and get my crime fighter keys.
I wonder what that jingling sound is I keep hearing. Let's check out the laundry. Maybe you dropped the key there. There goes that jingling again.
No luck, Sunset.
Let's go downstairs and check it out. I'll beat you down, Sunset. Whee! Sunset, there it is. This ain't no door key. This is a skate key.
Okay. I've got my super crime fighter key ring. We'll try every key. One of them should work.
That's your last key.
Hey, guys, there's a little opening up there. Maybe I could try to squeeze through it.
I don't like it, but we've tried everything else. Hold it now. Steady.
There's that jingling sound again.
Wrong way. That jingling sound is coming from you. What's that hanging on your sneaker?
Gosh, I forgot. Last time I lost my key, my mom tied it into my shoelace for safekeeping.
Well, at least he remembered to wear his shoes.
Oh, boy. Gee, Snuffy, I really hope there's some way that you can meet my friend Buffy.
Oh, you mean your imaginary friend, the Snuffleupagus?
It's not imaginary. Why, she's as real as you are.
Oh, sure, Bird. And what does this Snuffleupagus look like? Is she big and lumpy? Or is she striped? Or polka-dotted? Or green?
No, nothing like that. Why, you know, in order to know what she's like, you'd have to meet her. Say, maybe she's back by now. I'll go see if she's there, and you wait right here, okay?
Okay.
I want you to meet Buffy. Oh, hi, Buffy. There you are.
Hey, Bird.
Oh, this is your big chance to meet Mr. Snuffleupagus.
Well, Big Bird, at last, huh?
Yeah. Well, you wait right here, okay, Buffy? I'll go get him.
All right, Big Bird.
Come on, Snuff. At last, you're gonna meet my good friend, Buffy.
Oh.
Here's Buffy. Where is she?
Oh, why, here she is, Bird.
Huh?
Oh, nice to meet you, Ms. Buffleupagus.
No. There's nobody here. Snuffy, I'm trying to tell you that Buffy is really, really, really real.
Sure, Bird.
Well, she is. And, you know, she must have just gone into Oscar's trash can. That's where she lives, you know.
Wait, you're telling me that there is a Buffleupagus in Oscar's can?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Bird, you have some imagination. Oh, come on. Let's go back and play. Boy, next you're gonna tell me that he has a herd of wild elephants in there. Oh.
But Snobby.
Taller. Shorter. Taller. taller, shorter.
Excuse me.
Watch it, lady.
Pardon me, Sunny.
Down below the street, can you dig the steady beat? It's a subway.
Subway!
Moving right along, hear the rhythm loud and strong. It's the subway.
Subway! There isn't any room in this town.
We put all the trains down under the ground.
Buy a token now for a ride in Super Wow on the subway.
Subway!
You should say you're sorry.
Hi, Kermit.
We didn't
tie the door.
There's no room for me anymore.
On the subway.
Subway!
Hang on to the strap.
Wonder where they hit the map.
On the subway.
Subway!
Hurry, take the express.
It will go right by your local address.
Swaying to and fro, it's the only way to go on the subway.
Subway!
My topic went by.
Oh. Say your thoughts in my eyes.
Oh, so hot I could die.
Anyway.
Back inside a train, it's too crowded to complain on a subway.
Subway!
You can lose your purse or you might do something worse on the subway.
Subway!
Travel bargain in town.
The log is running, show on the ground.
Come on, step inside, you'll get taken for a ride on the subway.
Where's that?
On the subway.
It will go right by your local address.
Buy a token now or ride a Super Wow on the subway. On the subway.
On the subway.
On the subway.
Howdy, stranger.
Hello.
Wow, am I glad to see you.
Yes.
I'm plumb lost. Can you tell me the way to the city?
What's a city?
Well, a city. You know, a city.
No, I don't know.
Oh, well, here, look, I'll show you. See, a city has lots of, put up there, buildings, and stores, and houses.
I see.
And cars, buses, trains, and trucks. To bring all kinds of things in and out.
Uh-huh.
And cities have always got lots of people.
People?
Yes. Now, can you tell me the way to the city?
No, I'm afraid not. You see, I'm lost, too. By the way, what are
people? Page 7. Whoop. Where's my 7? Wait a minute. Where's my 7? Aha! 7.
One, two, three, four, five, six, 7! 7 piglets! 7!
Oh, boy, oh, boy.
What's the matter, Big Bird?
Oh, I'm so depressed.
Look, I wanted you to meet Snuffy so bad, and I wanted Snuffy to meet you, but he thinks you're a Buffleupagus. And so I say, There really is a Buffy, Snuffy. I will joke. But nobody believes me.
Oh, Big Bird, it's not as bad as all that. I know for one that Cody believes you.
You do, Cody?
And I believe you, too.
You do?
Sure I do.
But you've never even seen him.
Well, that doesn't matter. I can still believe in things that I haven't seen.
Really?
Sure I can. And I believe in Snuffleupagus. If you say he's there, and I believe, then make believe is something we can share with it. Imagination, make believe comes true. Watch what you can do with it. Imagination, you can travel far to another world. That's part of who you are. And I believe in Snuffleupagus.
Hey, you know, Snuffy's right back at my nest. I could... You want to go see him?
Well, you go, Bird, because Cody has to have his nap now.
Oh.
But I do believe you.
Oh, well, thanks, Buffy. Oh, Snuffy. Hey, Buffy's right out there on the steps.
Oh, yeah, sure. But every time I go out, she's gone.
Oh, but...
Oh, it's okay. It doesn't matter.
No.
No. I believe in Buffleupagus. I know how you feel. I can't see this Buffleupagus. But I know that she's real. With imagination, make believe comes true. You just use your mind and watch what it can do. Yes, there must be a Buffleupagus. You believe it too. I believe in Buffleupagus because I believe asleep. Well, I guess it's time to go home. Yeah. Oh, look, there's Cody. I wonder who that is with him. Oh, well. Bye-bye.
Oh, hi there. A Harley Knee Slapper here, and today I got a great joke to show you. See this closet here? Well, this closet is filled with toys. Yeah, I filled it all. I filled it all the way to the top with toys. And I closed the door. I put this sign right here on the closet. See? It says open. O-P-E-N. Open. What's going to happen, see, is somebody walks by and looks at this sign here and... Oh, excuse me, I get so funny. They're going to see the sign and open the door. And it's going to fall all over them. Oh, here comes somebody.
O-P-E-N. Open. Okay. Weird.
Lake. What a lovely looking lake.
Hi there again. It's me again. Yep. You know what I did? Well, didn't work last night, but now what I did is I filled the whole closet full of toys again. And it's going to work because I put the sign here on the closet door, see? It says O-P-E-N, open. And someone's going to come along and open it for sure now. Here comes somebody now.
O-P-E-N. Open. Okay. This door's stuck. It won't open.
Whoa! Wait a minute!
Turtle. There was an old turtle called Dan, who set sail in a garbage can. It started to rain, so he sailed back again and ended up where he began. Turtle.
Oh. Hi. I think I did it. I think the toys are all set in there again. Now, those other two times it didn't work. But now, it's going to be fantastic. See, we've got the sign on the door again. It says, open. O-P-E. And open. And all we have to do, see, is wait for somebody to come on line. It's going to be great.
Oh, open. O-P-E-N, open. Well, of course we'll have to open it if we're going to the theater. That's silly. Come on, George, have you got the tickets?
Yeah, Connie.
We're going to be late now.
Okay.
Don't forget to close the door.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, now, what's going on here?
Thank you. ever noticed how animals that eat crunchy foods and raw vegetables have nice teeth?
Hmm?
Animal smart.
Oh, cat.
Bert.
Hmm?
This may seem like a ridiculous question, but what are you doing?
Oh, I'm teaching Bernice here how to play checkers. Your move, Bernice. Bernice, your move.
You're teaching a pigeon to play checkers?
Mm-hmm.
Why, that's amazing. That's the most incredible thing I've ever heard of.
Oh, and it's no big deal.
No big deal?
Mm-mm.
Why a pigeon that can play checkers? That must be the smartest pigeon in the whole world.
Well, she's really not that smart, Ernie.
Not that smart, Bert? Mm-hmm. How can you say that?
Well, in the 10 games we've played,
She's
only beaten me twice. Okay, Bernice, go ahead, your move.
Oh, I must have dozed off. Hi, kids.
Snuffleupagus.
Where's the Buffleupagus?
No, Snuffleupagus.
Oh, he's right. Oh, where did he go? Gee, he was right here. Have you seen him?
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters L and T.
A feather?
And by the number 7. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.